It's writing time. Boys and girls, this was our last writing lesson for kindergarten. I cannot believe it. We've done so much writing this year. You've done all kinds of different kind of writing. And it's time to come to the end of our writing, but I hope you don't stop writing. Keep on all summer making up stories and writing and practicing. And then next year when you get to first grade, oh man, you're going to impress your teacher so much. But so I thought today I would show you one more important thing that I want you to think about before we finish for writing for kindergarten this year. I'm going to read you a story today called Goldilocks and the Three Dinosaurs. And I want you to really look at details in this story because we know writing is just telling things and putting it on paper. But we know that the pictures can give us lots of things that the words don't say. So we're going to look for lots of details in some of the pictures in this story. Now, you notice Goldilocks, we've heard of her before. Right? Goldilocks and the three bears. But this is Goldilocks and the three dinosaurs. So we're taking a story that's been told before, but changing it up and making it different and making it new. Now, the author of this is Mo Willems. Mo Willems writes the Pigeon books, remember? He writes the Elephant and Piggy books. He wrote that book we read the other day, We Are Growing, about the grass growing. So he is an author that we know, and he does a lot of cool stuff in his stories. So as we read today, Goldilocks and the Three Dinosaurs, let's see what he does with things that he keeps the same and things that he changes. And then let's also look at lots of details that he puts in his illustrations, because this will give you some ideas that you can use in your writing. All right. So let's read Goldilocks and the Three Dinosaurs. Here's our title page where we've got our title and our author. Now we said this is retold because really it's partially an old story, but partially a new story. Once upon a time, there were three dinosaurs, Papa Dinosaur, Mama Dinosaur, and some other dinosaur who happened to be visiting from Norway. Look at their sign on the wall, Home Sweet Dinosaur Home. One day, for no particular reason, the three dinosaurs made up their beds, positioned their chairs just so, and cooked three bowls of delicious chocolate pudding at varying temperatures. Now, we know with Goldilocks, let me move me over where you can see it a little better. With Goldilocks, they made three bowls of porridge, but look, they made three bowls of chocolate pudding and it said at varying temperatures. Remember the temperature, some was hot, some was cold, some was just right. Look, we've got some with ice cubes in it in here, getting it a little cooler. We've got some with a thermometer in it here, testing to see how hot it is. But look around it for different things on this page that might be very interesting. You might notice there's somebody hiding. Do you see who it is? There's a secret person hidden throughout this book. Look, it's the pigeon. He's hidden up there in the cookie jar. Mo Willems hid the pigeon in there for us. But look, here's Mama Dinosaur making up the bed. Here's the visitor from Norway bringing in some chairs. Think about the things that we know about Goldilocks. We know in Goldilocks there's three beds, there's three chairs, there's three bowls of porridge. Seeing some things that are similar, but yet Mo Willems has changed it up a little bit. He's got pudding instead of porridge. Well, let's see what happens in this story. So here's our visitor from Norway carrying a chair in. Mama's making up the bed. Let's see what happens. Oh boy, said Papa Dinosaur in his loud, booming voice. It's finally time to leave and go to the someplace else. Yes, continued Mama Dinosaur. I sure hope no innocent little succulent child happens by our unlocked home while we are someplace else. What are they saying? What someplace else are they going to go to? They're looking very suspicious. They said the door was unlocked. The other dinosaur made a loud noise that sounded like a big evil laugh, but it was probably just a polite Norwegian expression. So the three dinosaurs went someplace else and were definitely not hiding in the woods waiting for an unsuspecting kid to come by. Look at him sneaking out. Waiting in the woods for a kid to come by? Why do you think they want a kid to come by? Well, sure enough, 5 minutes later, a poorly supervised little girl named Goldilocks came traipsing along. Just then, the forest boomed with what could have been a dinosaur yelling, "Gotcha!" I'm pretty sure it was just the wind. The loud noise was immediately followed by another loud noise that sounded kind of like, "Be patient, Papa Dinosaur. The trap is not yet sprung." But that could have been a rock falling or a squirrel. Look at the sign there. It says 2 miles to trap. And they've marked out trap and it says to a very nice house. Well, either way, Goldilocks was not the type of little girl who listened to anyone or anything. For example, Goldilocks never listened to warnings about the dangers of barging into strange, enormous houses. So as soon as Goldilocks came across a strange, enormous house, she barged right in. Look at her going in. The mat says, "Welcome," and then it says, "Tee-hee-hee-hee." They're trying to trap Goldilocks, aren't they? Immediately, Goldilocks smelled the 3 bowls of chocolate pudding. "Mmm," said Goldilocks, "that chocolate pudding smells delicious. If only I could get all the way to the top of that counter." Then Goldilocks noticed a very tall ladder that just happened to be there and certainly wasn't left on purpose. Well, Goldilocks climbed to the top of the ladder and found herself face to face with 3 gigantic bowls of chocolate pudding. Why are the bowls so gigantic? Why is the counter so tall? Because it's a dinosaur's house, right? That's why those things are that way. I think they've set a trap for Goldilocks, haven't they? Well, the first bowl of chocolate pudding was too hot, but Goldilocks ate it anyway because, hey, it's chocolate pudding, right? And the second bowl of chocolate pudding was too cold. But who cares about temperature when you've got a bowl of chocolate pudding? Not her. Look at her dunking her head in. The third bowl of chocolate pudding was just right. But Goldilocks was on such a roll by now, she hardly even noticed. Look at Goldilocks and the mess she's making, eating all this chocolate pudding. Oh, she's eating all 3 bowls. That's different from the 3 bears, isn't it? Because in the 3 bear story, she didn't eat them all, did she? Well, soon Goldilocks was stuffed, look at her, like one of those delicious chocolate-filled little girl bonbons, which, by the way, are totally not the favorite things in the whole world for a hungry dinosaur. Tired and groggy, Goldilocks noticed 3 chairs in the living room, so she climbed down the ladder and walked out of the kitchen. The first chair was too tall. The second chair was too tall. Well, they are dinosaur chairs, aren't they? So that seems to be why they would be too tall. That's different from the 3 bears, isn't it? Look at those chairs, though. Look, did you see those feet on them? And the third chair was too tall. Goldilocks wasn't going to climb that high just to sit in some chair. So she hiked over to the bedroom. When she got there, Goldilocks noticed that the beds were also gigantically big. "What's going on around here?" groaned the exhausted girl. "The bears that live here must be nuts." So she thinks she's in the bear's house. She doesn't know she's in the dinosaur house, does she? Oh, my goodness. Well, just then, the room filled with a loud booming noise that was either a passing truck or a dinosaur gloating. "A few more minutes and she'll be asleep. Delicious chocolate-filled little girl bonbons are the yummier when they're rested." Well, even a little girl who never listens to anyone or anything had to hear that. Now, look real close. Look at how we see. Goldilocks is inside the house here, but look. We can see outside the windows. You see how Mo Willems has taken the details in the setting? And now he's given us 2 settings. We see inside and we see outside. He is so talented how he shows us the different parts of the story in this picture. Lots of details. And look at the beds. Mama Dinosaur's bed, Papa Dinosaur's bed, and look, our visitor from Norway. Look, we can tell it's the visitor's bed. There's his suitcase, and look, this is his little flag on the end of the bed. That's a flag of the country from Norway. So he's given us lots of details in these pictures. So remember, we said a good artist and a good storyteller gives us lots of extra details in the pictures. So I love how he's made us be able to see the inside and the outside. Well, Goldilocks took a minute to stop and think. There she is thinking up there, which was longer than she was used to stopping and thinking. Hey, she told herself, this isn't some bear's house. This is a dinosaur's house. So, what do you like about Goldilocks? She was no fool. As quickly as she could, she ran to the back door and she got out of there. Look at the mat. It says, wipe your talons. The talons, the claws. Well, just then, a loud plane flew by, which sounded pretty much like a trio of dinosaurs yelling, "Now charge!" or the Norwegian expression for "Chewy bun bun dime!" But suddenly, and completely coincidentally, the three dinosaurs rushed through the front door, but they were too late. Look, she's gone out the back door. She's gone. Look right here. See? My Willems has done his trick us again. Look, he's put the pigeon there in the frame on the table. Look at the dinosaur lamp. And notice how we can see the outside and we can see the inside. He's showing us all about the setting using his pictures. So he is doing so much for us in these pictures. Well, Goldilocks was gone, and that all that was left in the house were three disappointed dinosaurs. And look what it says right here, the end. But the moral to this story is, if you ever find yourself in the wrong story, leave. And look where she went. She went to the three bears' house. And the moral for the dinosaurs is, lock the back door. If they had locked the back door, Goldilocks wouldn't have gone or what gotten away, would she? I love that story because Mo Willems showed us so many different things through his details in the pictures. Well, it's time for you to do your writing, work on your fiction story. You may have a story that you've already been working on, or you may be ready to start a new story today. Either way is fine. Remember, we do our very best. We stretch out words to spell them the best we can. We think of words that we know that we are sight words that we've learned. We think about ways to spell words that we've learned, like things like our robber Y, super sneaky silent E, all those things that we've learned. When we spell, we do our very best. We don't have to ask anybody how to spell. We just do the best we can. And is it perfect? No, it's not always perfect, but it's just the very best that we can do. And I hope you can use some ideas like Mo Willems had. He used a lot of details in his pictures to give us lots of extra things that we can find out. And he just snuck little things in there. And we've seen other books where somebody sneaks a little something on every page. Sometimes that's fun to do in a fiction story. So I can't wait to hear your writing today. This is your last one for you guys to read to me. And I can't wait to hear what you've done. You have done so much work this year, and I'm so proud of you. And I can't wait to see what magnificent writing you're going to do today.